In this video, I'm going to show you a mountain PyCharm. So I use PyCharm all the time because it has really many professional features, which I use a lot. So I have the professional edition, which you can get as a student for free. However, you can also get the community edition for free anyway, which has basically all the features except the one that I'm using sometimes. Okay, so first of all, this is how it looks. So I have a tab with my project files to the left. In the middle, there would be the editor. However, I have many tabs where I can add stuff. For example, I have a terminal here at the bottom where I can run normal terminal commands. I have a Python console at the bottom where I can run Python commands, which also has a variable editor here. And I have version control support, list my to-dos. Here I have a SkyView, database view, etc., etc. Okay, so let's start by making a new project. So I select new project and then pure Python. I have a selection of other things I could also add. So now if I create a new project, I'm always creating a new kernel environment. So this is what we should do. If you're creating your homework, well, of course, then you use our existing Python environment, which I could select here. I could select more here, so I can create new ones even more here. I could select an existing environment, or what I'm normally doing all the time in creating a new environment. So I can select between conda, pipenv, and virtualenv, and I could even create more using this here. Okay, so now I'm creating this. Creating this actually in a new window. Now it takes around 10 seconds to create the environment. I'm gonna pause. Okay, done. Now it's still a bit busy with indexing, but that only takes another 10 seconds. Now in my project here, normally, if I had a virtual env, I would have the env here, but the conda env is obviously, as you know, not inside my directory here, but it belongs to my project. Now I can simply select new and then Python file here, give it a name, my file, and inside this I can, for example, print hello world. So you see already I have a lot of suggestions what I could add here. This is PyCharm in part, but also in part another a plugin called Kite. I could, for example, control and space, and I could listed everything I could print here, everything which is there. So many professional features. Okay, so now if I want to run it, well, I could either open the terminal and run this in the terminal, python myfile.py, which works. But I can also right click this and then select run myfile. Now this is going to open in a run dialog, which is simply just responsible for running this very file. So it runs python myfile. So if I copy this to the terminal, it will work just as well and do the same thing. Okay, so like I said, it automatically creates an environment for this, and it always opens my file inside this environment. So also, if I open normal terminal, it will also be this environment is going to be open. Okay, I also have Git integration, for example, here in PyCharm. So if I change back to my other file, we see that here this is Git repository, and we see, for example, that stuff that is added to Git is green, where stuff that is not added to Git is red. And I can simply right-click Git add, and thus now the file here is green. Okay, and I also have Git features like committing here in my editor. All right, so now also my Python console to come back this year. So if I have more complex variables here, I have them here in my variable editor, which is also really nice. And I could even delete this variable, for example, or change its value to something else. Now a is 4. What I can also do is, well, if I import NumPy, then make a NumPy array, I could show that also nicely. But what do I see here? I cannot import NumPy. And also in this file, I cannot import NumPy. It suggests me to import as np, because this is what I normally do. So if I now run it, it's going to tell me there's no module called NumPy. Why that? Well, because the kernel environment I just created doesn't have NumPy. So what do? I go to File, Settings, and then to my project here, Project Interpreter, and I see this is the environment I'm using. It's a conda environment, and NumPy is not listed here. I can simply install NumPy like this. So I select NumPy, and I install the package. So this is how you do this in PyCharm. What I could do, however, instead, is I could select another project interpreter. So imagine I didn't want to use this one, but I wanted to use my, God, I have so many environments here. my scientific programming environment. So this takes now a bit too long because this is bigger. And yeah, it's still indexing a bit, which takes some time, but now it should work. And now if I'm executing my file, if I'm running my file, it runs and it successfully imports NumPy. Right, so this is how I select the project interpreter for my entire project. I could also have a different project interpreter for this very file I'm running. So to do so, this here is the dialog of the files I recently ran. So imagine I created a new file, file 2. Now if I want to run this, I have a selection of what I previously ran right here. So now I can run my file or file 2. And I can also edit this. These are then the one configurations. And just like this, I can edit the one configurations here. So this here tells me where the script is, what parameters I'm using it with, for example, argparse, and also what the interpreter it's going to use. And I can change that back to some other interpreter. I'm not sure. I think all of these have NumPy, so I could select for this one another one. Okay.